Hey everybody, Danielle here, and happy Friday. Hope you're having an excellent week, and thanks for tuning in and checking out this video today. So, if you haven't heard, I have tons of Facebook Lives on this page right now because I am doing one new one every day for 4 weeks. And this is actually marking the end of the second week. So, officially halfway through at the end of today's video. So it's all in celebration of 4 years since starting the Sedge and wanting to take some time to reflect on what were kind of the biggest lessons learned over those 4 years and what was I thinking about and working on at each stage along the way. Because I know a lot of you guys are in those years right now and or maybe just starting out or maybe closer to the 4 year mark like myself. And so I think it's a good opportunity to do some behind the scenes sharing and stories, and also flipping those into those lessons learned into opportunities for you to make some improvements or kind of catch yourself if you're doing something or thinking or feeling something that might be similar to what I'm sharing in these lessons learned. So if you're here live, thanks for coming. You want to let me know where you're tuning in from, that'd be great. And if you have any questions, feel free to pop them in and we'll kind of have a chat about it. But the topic today is all about setting boundaries. And this is one I probably still have trouble with this. It's funny because looking, doing this exercise, I'm starting to notice some themes in lessons learned and how maybe there's a few things that haven't been fully learned yet because they might be coming up again in different ways. So it's actually really valuable for me to go through this process as well. So in terms of boundaries, when you're, especially when you're starting out and you're still trying to get a sense of your service or your product and really nail your offering, it's tempting, to want to be everything to everybody and to not really stick to many processes or boundaries in your business because you want to be open to receiving what other people are asking you for, and you kind of feel like you need to be fully available to them because if they're giving you some time and attention, you want to serve them, and maybe you don't have those boundaries set up yet. So this was a topic that I was definitely learning and practicing in my second year. And so I had, if you watched yesterday's video, I talked about the first pilot program of the Boost Academy, which was a group program where we went for 6 weeks together and went through a bunch of different content and modules, all the steps that you need to get your business going. And so what I ran into, like the pilot was great, but around that, I can't even remember if it was before or after, but it attracted some people who wanted to work one-on-one with me as well and kind of go through that program, but have that check-in one-on-one. And so at the time, I thought, well, that's great. Like, it's more access to your customer and your client, and getting to know them better is only going to help get clarity on your offer and how it's valuable to them so that you can keep improving it and refining it. So that is all wonderful, and I definitely encourage people to do that in any way they can. But I think you need to be careful about setting boundaries in those cases because it can really grow into a bigger scope or a bigger time commitment than you originally thought it would be. And if you just let it kind of go loosey-goosey, that's very easy for that to happen. So even if you're doing some more one-on-one type of work or doing some offerings, some services that might be a little bit outside of what you want to deliver in the future, but you know it's valuable because it puts you in better connection with your audience, then I would recommend you really take some time at the beginning to establish those boundaries. So think specifically about how much time you want to put in, given that you are going to get some extra insight and information out of that relationship. And really just be conscious and mindful about how much time you're committing to in that new kind of client relationship, and also the scope. and actually have that discussion with the person before you start. So instead of, like in my case, I was just excited to work with someone one-on-one, and it actually happened with two different people, and these relationships ended up kind of blowing into these very time intensive relationships. And it was good on one hand that I was getting to know them better and get more insight about what they needed and how I could help them. So that was great. But looking back, I think it would have been better to do that within a certain scope and certain boundaries. And so if I were to do that over again, I would, you know, commit to having a deeper relationship with them because it was early on in the development of this course, this Boost Academy course, but really be clear, like, hey, this piece, this one-on-one coaching that we're doing every week is above and beyond what the course will be. And I want you to know that. And I'm happy to do it at the same price because it's valuable for me too. But here's where the boundaries are. We're not going to email, you know, every day. We're not going to have 2-hour long calls. You really need to set up that structure so that it's productive and efficient use of your time, and also it serves your customer better as well. So not only be mindful of the time commitment you want to make before you start working with someone and the scope, but also voice that and actually have the conversation so that everybody's on the same page. And then the next step of that, of course, is to keep those boundaries. So if somebody who you're working with is still overstepping what you've discussed was the plan, you need to be okay to say, look, I'm so excited that you're enthusiastic about this, but here's what we agreed. So if you need more support than that, we should have another conversation about what that could look like. But for now, here's what we planned, and let's stick to that. So yeah, that was a tough lesson learned for me. And the other piece of that is when you're kind of allowing your boundaries to shift in the pursuit of having that greater understanding of your customer or how your offer delivers value to them, you also want to be really clear on which piece of the puzzle you're testing, and you know, decide upfront how much time you need to spend testing that and what the outcome is that you're looking for, so that you know when it's done, when you know. So that you have kind of a finish line where when you reach that outcome or that time frame that you've decided at the beginning, you can make an informed decision about either changing course or like iterating or changing whatever it is you're doing. But if you don't set that time frame or that finish line from the beginning, then you can just kind of drift further down into the future, and you might not you won't give yourself that signpost to stop and evaluate whatever you were testing and really determine what the outcome was so that you can make your next decision. So I guess in essence, it all comes down to being really mindful of your time, being strategic with how you are testing your idea in the early stages so that you're protecting your boundaries and not being everything to everybody and draining your time because you want to be open to a certain extent, but also save some of your energy and bandwidth for improving your business and so that it can grow and serve even more people. So if you let yourself get sucked into kind of a narrow scope with just one or a few people, it's not in service of everybody else who needs to hear from you. So this is a big, big lesson. And basically, in a nutshell, it's, you know, keep your main thing the main thing and make all your decisions around supporting that. And don't let yourself get pulled in different directions. And the best way to do that is to be mindful and clear about what your objective is and what you're trying to determine in this next step of your business, whether that's 1 month or 3 months or whatever that time frame is that you decide. So that's pretty much it for my lesson learned on boundaries and my advice for you if you're in that stage as well and testing out your offer, whether that's, and again, this time commitment thing comes into play a lot if you're doing a service or working one-on-one with people or even in a small group. But even if you're doing a product or some other type of business model and you're in that customer research and insight phase, it's important to connect with those people, but be mindful about where the edges are on your time and how you're using that information as you go forward. And that way you can avoid going down rabbit holes or, you know, losing some of that valuable time. So I hope that was helpful for you guys. If you have any questions, let me know. And that's, yeah, something that takes practice, I think. And I'm still practicing, even though it's 2 years later from when this lesson was first brought into my life as it relates to running my business. Okay, so have a great weekend, and I will be back live streaming every day next week and talking all about lessons learned in year 3 of running This Edge. And actually, for the next 2 weeks, a lot of lessons will come in also from my other project, Changemakers Association, and the Global Social Entrepreneurs Lab, because those two things started to develop in the third and fourth years after running This Edge or starting This Edge. And it's all connected. And so I'll talk a little bit about how that fits together and how I've been prioritizing different goals within multiple projects and managing my time. I'll also talk about burning out a little bit and how you can maybe be more mindful of that too. Okay, so we'll talk soon. Have a great weekend. Bye.